good call.
Sword dancers wield dual blade using high speed combos and instant attacks as their main combat style. Instant attack. Henrik's instant attacks is a powerful variant form. When you use a normal attack, skill 1 or 2, hitting an enemy, using another skill will trigger an instant attack of the skill and vice versa. I cannot trigger instant attacks with artifacts and non-class attacks. Huh. Confused ones may not exert their full strength. This is, you're giving this to me. I feel like my empty heart was being mended. It turns out that this is the ego lost due to the reshape. If you're willing to give me more soul echoes, I'll definitely help you when I recover. And I only need 30? Minions of Chaos kill my family, and I came here on a clear purpose to eliminate them all. Huh. Sola, Vanguard. Vanguards use spears to perform medium range attacks and leap attacks as their main combat. Leap attacks some of Sola's class skills. She can bounce herself to the enemy into the air at the moment of hitting them and use more combos in the air and other types of attacks cannot trigger. I guess that's it, but 1, 2, 3. Dash attack. Two attacks in the air plus a dash, I guess. 1, 2. I wonder why she was so cheap to behind the gate. Change character. Talk. I salute you, fellow warrior of the 12 gods. Since I embarked on the pilgrimage and never stayed in one place for so long. Let's try the blade dancer. Wow, why was it so expensive? What's up, Henrik the Blade of Ali, at your service.
Good call.
Check manual. Playtime 30. There's no way I only played for 35 minutes, really? No, there are only two more relics left to unlock. A bunch of fire. How do I? Let me view them. Igni. I unlocked 6 out of 12. Still collected incompletely, but I can't see what the other cards do, which is weird. Except the dummy. Switch skill. We have, how did we get different abilities? Launch. My uppercut ability. That's my XXX combo. it means by these instant attacks, guard is... launch ability? Why did I turn red just to attack? What's dead? Why aren't I doing my just attack anymore? Huh. Kind of confused. What? Not a big fan of this character. What? How am I not guarding? So I can't parry with this guy? Huh. What? How am I getting the jump attack going? That's so weird. Okay, I'm not a fan of this character much. Confused ones may not exert their full strength. My spearhead will launch the punishment of gods to chaos. No perfect blocks for me. Aw, man. But I got the range. Resetting the dummy. Spinning. Why are some of these things locked? Oh wow, they cost soul points. Unlock different combos. Okay, that's new. I don't think the fighter has anything to unlock.
No turning back.
Fearless charge, though. We can unlock fearless charge eventually. Diving slash. These are my ground attacks. Okay. I don't know. The fighter seems pretty awesome. Talents. Awaken. How do you get different awaken skills? Those cost. Quite a bit of soul. Survival loots. Finishing a room, get coin, like getting passive coin might be nice. Reduces the cost to refresh items. Potions have stronger when leveling up. Potion at rest here is recover health. We get, oh, we bought one of these to increase damage dealt. This is level one. Oh, you have to unlock it. You unlock it and then you put points into it. That's kind of damn. So to unlock it, it costs, you know, level 100, level 0, you get a buff. Okay, I think I'm gonna have to put points into this. Jeez. Talented. I wonder what the max level is here, so I kind of want to up this. 20% extra void crystals. Okay, level 4 is the max. Okay. Is there only one portal? Because there are two to the sides of this one. I guess I could jump through this, right? Attacks now have extra effects. Wind's Child was cool. Will increase each stack of wind erosion will increase 6% chance of enemy taking critical hits for 8 seconds. Reduces the enemy's attack one time for 60 seconds. Okay. It's good crowd control. Oh, not blazing shield. Oh, dang it. Okay, moving on. normal attacks will now have... Oh, normal attacks will now have the sweep effect, not just... Wait, I thought we had that. Dodge in the air. Create a small firebomb when dodge ends, dealing this much damage. Physical damage increased 20% in 15 seconds after launch skill. Some stacks affect. Max HP increased 30%. Critical damage decreased 20%. Probably meteor arrow. I need to launch the enemies into the air more. Oops, I'm getting... Yeah, that's really cool that my basic attacks have shockwaves. Void Realm, all enemies. It's so worth it to do this. The timed instances. Well, it seems worth it. Void crystals, nice. I want more void crystals. Air attacks now have a shockwave effect. Triggering a perfect block will give you some health back. Basic elemental damage increase, but advanced elemental damage is decreased. Elemental damage under certain conditions, you can consume all stacks. Oh. Basic elemental damage would go up by 50%. Just dodge will create a 3.5 times attack damage whirlwind blade and inflict stacks of wind erosion. I think he just dodges a perfect dodge. Elite enemies. Enhance your potion. You can pray here. That's always good. Two fighting will. Let's see about enhancing the potion. Increase recovery. First we heal. And then. What happens when we recovery up? Do we get... Yeah, we get all of our potions back. Wind. Looks like we're gonna go for wind. Although thunders has been nice. Thunderstone. Dodge will create damage shock bomb. When an enemy is critically hit, a thunderstorm will deal 0.8 attack power damage after hitting. After hitting, the enemy gets shocked. Normal attacks will inflict shocked, weakening the resistance of elite enemies or bosses. Okay. All enemies. Kill all enemies under a certain time to get more rewards. Yeah, it's really expensive to use my awakened ability. Normal attacks will inflict frost, slowing down the enemies. Artifact damage, 10% off store items can be stacked. I mean, sure, diamond dust, okay. Oh, let's see, large of enemies drop souls. Does that mean increased amount of drop rare relics or massive resources? Let's just go here. Oh, I am just taking all those hits like a chump. Attack me. Whoops. Oops. Oh wow, he actually got me good. He's getting me good. Elimination complete. That was rough. That was a little bit rough. Air attacks now have an extra effect. Okay. Soul echoes actually obtained increases by 3. Dodge will create a bomb. Obtain 1 coin for every hit taken. Soul echoes, I guess. All right, let's go kill all enemies instead of going to the land of opportunity. I probably should have gone to the land of opportunity because I think I can get more souls. Oh, I can use my ability here. Oh, I can turn it on and off the awakened ability. Oh, I didn't do it on time, did I? Oh man, challenge code. Ah, I was looking at other crap. Damn it. Ten percent off store items, and can it be stacked? Physical damage increase when in the air. Okay, attack damage. Formless sword. Attack damage increased by 60%. Damage taken increases 30%. Can be stacked. Jesus. not allowed to make any purchases. Bummer. Okay, the number of potions. Fire. I wonder what light does. Fire though. Normal attacks will burn. Every 5 seconds automatically fires a rolling fire spell, which is pretty awesome. The last time I got that, just dodge will create a flame area. Fire saw dealing 1.2 times the attack damage and inflicts a stack of burn to enemies hit. Sounds pretty nice. Although normal attacks would be nice too. I'm gonna have to see what an all fire build can do. I wonder if that would, I'd be screwing myself over by doing something like that. Do your thing. He's got stacking fire damage. Oh, he's out. Potions, that guy's a pushover. Mask of Weep, ground physical damage increases 30%, can be stacked, which is pretty nice. Like critical chance to advance elemental damage. Let's see, increase physical damage increases 10%. 15 seconds after dashing, the same effects stack up to 50% at most. Flame Wheel is awesome. Alright, some guy I think just seems to have fallen down there. Dude, it's a flaming wolf. How's it taking damage? Yeah, the flaming wheel is pretty nice. It goes through enemies. Disease spreaded. Every additional god your relic belong to will increase overall crit rate. Wow. Critical rate increase by 5% can be stacked. Void crystals actually obtained increase by 10%. Nice. Just go elite hunting. How's he broken again? Whoa. Got a lot of gold. Gotta have an air dodge. Alright, wind stuff. This is light. Artifact charging speed is faster when dark damage occurs. The critically hit enemy will experience an airflow wave that causes damage, giving the hit enemy a stack of erosion. Faster when wind damage occurs. Like when I take wind damage, or kill all enemies in time to receive reward. Artifact, upgrade resonance, purchase new artifact, summon a light shield dealing 3.5 times. Dazzle will reduce the enemy's attack. I forgot about that for 8 seconds. Might as well. Increase physical damage but lower elemental damage. Formless sword. I can stack this. Smash skills will create Thunder Strike and trigger Surge on shocked enemies. Hammer of God. Dang. This is tough. Artifacts and health, I think. Trial ground, elite. This guy again? What the heck? Those elites. That elite's pretty easy. Let's see. Relics. Kill all enemies. Let's Let's see if we can re-kill all enemies before the time runs out. I'm just gonna run in there. A bit of damage there. They hit hard. Every additional god here relic. Every additional god your relic belong to increase the HP by 4. Apply critical chance to basic elemental damage. That applies critical chance to base. That could be nice. For every ailment on the enemy, they receive 6% damage. I do have a lot of elemental effects. Okay, another elite fight here. This guy again? Jeez, melted, what the heck? Triggering perfect defense, restore 4% of my HP. After a successful defense, receive no damage. Don't know if that's just with my shield up, I take no damage anymore. Normally I was taking 1. Artifact charging speed faster when thunder occurs. That could be cool. Damage taken decreased by 10%, which is nice. Land of opportunity. More gold that I can spend on souls and void crystals. High stack of bleed when attacking. Each stack of bleed will make its bearer take additional damage. I do need that to pursue relentlessly when the bosses break value to 0 and falls to the ground, take 3% damage. So many good things. Upgrade resonance. Wow, this is a 1% or 1-time increase. Kind of want the bleed, honestly. Trial ground. Let's fight the elites. They've been a pushover so far.
Thank you.
you. 32, 45%. I'm gonna recover like half my health at this point. Prayer altar, I have 3 wind. I have a lot of no element. Chronometer, artifact charging speed 100%. Basic elemental damage increased 30%. Usually you can get this power directly from the 6th elemental god's relics, according to artifacts. Increase 100% chronometer, so that means I get to use my left joystick and right joystick more often. Terrible. So this thing's fired. Does my fire attack do anything to it? Heal. I'm gonna run around the map here while he does this. This fireball's keep coming at me. I don't wanna get hit by that. That's a lot of damage. Nice. Easy game. Replenish my pots. Dude, I'm super strong at this round. What the heck? May launch skills create a cyclone trigger something. Set up store items. Apply critical chance to elemental damage. Yeah, that sounds good. Sucks because they get. What the heck was that? Try to dodge there. What the heck? Alright, we're getting pulled in. those things that spawn on the ground. They pull you in and... taking those hits. Can dodge twice in the air? Tears, damage dealt to enemies with less than 30% HP increase. That's kind of nice. Soul pot. Dodge to create a wind. Ground physical attacks increased by 10%. See what the elites are in this stage, in this world. Okay, simple enough. I used my revive. I wasn't expecting that. Wasn't expecting so much damage and that burst damage. Enemies caught in a quicksand. Oops. Oh, we don't want to get caught in the quicksand. quicksand, get out of the quicksand. Spell castles are kind of annoying. Whoa, that guy came out of nowhere. Nice, got two. Why is it hard for me to... Okay. We can fight an elite, I think. If it's that ninja guy, we really need to watch out for his burst damage or not get so complacent. Ninja, ninja, ninja. Break. Dodge that. Oh, big damage when you get hit by that. Wind. Don't I already have this one? The chariot advanced elemental damage is increased. Every additional god. Wait, my HP will go to 140? Are you kidding me? Hell yeah. Void realm, kill enemies in a certain amount of time. Enhance your. Go here. I could enhance my potions, I guess. Oh shoot, maybe I should have done that. Vortex there, nice. Did I get caught in that? Okay, they don't get stunned when you hit them, I guess because they're made of rock. That would make sense if that's the case. Skill mastery. Restore HP. Stunning artwork. Action speed increases. 10% can be stacked a chariot, increases elemental damage. Dream crushing. Smash skills will create an explosion. They'll trigger deflagration. I have 1,000 void crystals, so I'm happy with that. The detonation. Yeah, my attacks don't cause fire though, which is kind of a bummer. Out pretty good. Meteor arrow physical damage increases 10%, 15 seconds after a launch skill, same effect stacks up to 50%. Physical damage is increased by 20%, 5 seconds after a smash skill. Tend to do the smash quite a bit. Elite enemies, all defeat all enemies. Let's go into the void realm. I have to heal. Thank you. have so much health.
Ah.
Damn, I didn't realize there would be so many enemies. Frozen bottle, dash skills will create something and you're frozen. Damage dealt to enemies with less than 30% HP is increased by 20%. Elemental damage is increased 50%, but physical damage is decreased. Every relic on you will increase the overall crit rate. Wow. For every elemental ailment on the enemy, damage they receive is increased by 2%. Increases elemental damage. I think I'm gonna get the great. Yeah, I'll just upgrade this. Fine. Then get the apple. Super tanky boy. Physical damage. Physical damage increase 10% in 50 seconds after a launch skill. Stunning artwork, action speed. Action speed increase. Action speed increase by 30%. Probably. I think that means I attack faster. Was supposed to heal myself. Okay, we must win. It's Thrall. And he spawns enemies too? Ooh, what a cheap. Oh, something's happening. Summoning something. Okay, he's got whirlwinds on the ground. What the heck? Whirlwinds. arrows. Oh. That's a lot of damage. Oh my god, what is that? Alright, I gotta kill the ads. These guys are annoying. I don't know where, how I was getting those dodges. This guy's pretty rough. Oh, we don't want to be caught in that vortex. Dude. Oh my god. Healing. Oh my god. There's some... Oh, yeah, yeah. I got hit by that again. What the heck? The smash is not good. Last health potion. Yes, nice. Okay, look out, clear time, rooms, fives. Is that it? You must be wondering why you're back here, right? The old man is confused too. Maybe it has something to do with the nothingness. Let the old man think. Oh, this stone in your hand is interesting. The old man haven't seen the Grail Oath Stone for a long time. It is said that believers of the old god would inscribe the oath on the Grail, then break it, and each carry a piece of Grail Oath Stone to remember the mission. Okay. Back here again? No! Seems we missed some part. The geezer must have hidden something. Pasulidus must have changed something. The way we woke up this time is different from reshaping. The keeper must know something. There's only one portal. Yes, yes, the old man knows it. In the nothingness, times and spaces are independent. Meanwhile, the power of chaos has also been separated, which gives the Awakeners a better chance of defeating their enemies. Now that you've got the Grail Oathstone. You may be able to find the answer by putting it in the shrine on the second floor. The old man also have some good stuffs for you. Time to try a new weapon. Aw. Okay, this is new. Need more oath stones to complete the grail. Oh boy. Greetings. Wait, we can change weapons? Whoa. What are these? Blood seal, elemental damage 4%, true god's grace. Wood crystals gain 10%, soul echoes plus 2. How do we. Choose a weapon to fight with. I get plus 3% to my attack going with this one. Okay, so there's more currency that we can use to get more upgrades. Okay. Awaken. So this is what we've been using. Causes earthquakes when walking. Fate of reincarnation derived from the god of death. Erlictus can convert fading lives into our own vitality. Seems like there's a life leech component to that. Echoes collector. Also refreshing items in the store, I don't really care. Elite rooms. Pierce. Is increased. Wait, are there new kill a boss gain and okay, yeah, there's new stuff added. Extra loots is new. Kill a boss to obtain a chance to pray. Always prepared when finishing a room. Recover 30 HP. Tough journey, elite room. Elite room appear, chance slightly increased, bargaining. Let's see if we can max out Echoes Collector. Okay. Upgraded to the max level. Revive, I could get more revives. Increase max HP. Maybe we'll do damage. Increase attack by 2. In finishing a room, you recover awaken. That's nice. Let's probably unlock each one to level 1 at least. Robust. Those are really cheap. Bargaining. Battleground sweeper. Tough journey. I don't know why. Maybe. Extra loots though. Okay. Let's see what the other weapons that we unlock give us.
Good call.
So we need to win 4 different times to unlock the next part. Anything you need? Change weapon, trade. Night Raven. What about? Whoops. Didn't mean to take a potion. Trade. What can you get? Oh, you can get more echoes. Okay. That's useful. Like unlocking more of these, that is. Fancy. What did it say second? Primal Flurry, Swallow Whirl, Rapid Moonblade, Dash Attack, Rising Slash. Slash upwards, jump in the air and launch the enemy. But doesn't our launch ability already do that? Okay. Cool.